hard to believe that gold medal victory was a year ago today for the American women's team. Amazing. And it's been quite a year for Kendall Coyne, who joins us now. Kendall, we saw the clip of you, obviously, at the All-Star festivities. There's been a lot of hype around that, deservedly so. But we got to start with this video that we've discovered of your husband taking a lap around the rink. When he told you he wanted to do this, what was your reaction?
At first I was like, are you serious? And then he's like, yeah, I'm serious. He's like, if I'm coming out here, that's what I'm doing.
Well, he made it.
he did. We're all still here.
Yeah. He started, I think, sometime in early February. And we are now in later in the month. So congratulations to him. And congratulations to you on just an unbelievable last couple of weeks. We got to see you out in San Jose. You were just terrific in the skills competition. And you got to work doing some stuff with NBC. So I want to ask you about that lap. What do you think about now? It's been a couple of weeks. What's the thing that comes to mind right away when you think about that moment?
When I think about that moment, there's a lot of things that go through my head, but the biggest thing is how many people have been inspired and how many people have changed the way that they perceive the game, whether it's they picked up the sport for the first time or they've wanted to watch a women's hockey game for the first time. But I feel that the world has been inspired through the sport of hockey from that moment.
What goes through your mind when you think about a year ago, you guys were playing in the gold medal game, and obviously the result was positive?
Absolutely, and it's crazy to sit back and think it's been a year since that moment. And when I came home from the Olympics, and I think for all of us, we saw a whole nother generation inspired to want to play the game, and that's how a lot of us started, was back in 1998 when we saw the women win. So we know the power and the impact putting that gold medal around our neck has. And I've definitely felt that in the last 365 days.
And I'm sure you felt it even more so after that moment at All-Star Weekend as well. I mean, I'm sure tons of people in general are approaching you when they see you to talk about it, but how many young girls have you come across over the last couple of weeks that are saying, I want to do what you do?
Oh, it's been unbelievable. You just gave me the chills down my back. And when we won the Olympics, I was so excited because I knew how many people it was going to touch. However, I don't think I immediately realized how many people, being the first woman to compete in the NHL All-Star Skills Competition, would impact. And it's definitely impacted the world and all the young girls. It's been unbelievable just to see, I mean, three to six-year-olds doing laps on the ice for the first time. and adults, too. I mean, look at my husband, for example.
Yeah.
He's still doing it.
Yeah, that's right.
But I think what also has been really cool is to hear from a lot of parents saying, my son wants to skate as fast as you. And that's been pretty special,
that
too.
That is really cool.
Yeah, no question. I want to go back to that gold medal game because it was, I mean, I can remember watching it. I was a nervous wreck watching it. So I don't know how you guys were playing in it. But what's the thing you remember about as it wound down to the end?
Well, to be honest, we got a penalty right at the end of the game. And
I remember.
And I just remember thinking to myself, not again. I can't let this sit like this for another 4 years. Not again, because that would be a very similar loss to 2014. We killed off the penalty, and as soon as we killed off that penalty, I knew we were going to win the game.
Wow,
that's that confidence that you get for being with a team that you really trust. I just have a question for you. Behind you, I see your jersey. I see one from one of your husbands. Who's got more jerseys up on the wall? Are those the only two right there?
I think he has me beat because he's got that one and that one. But I think mine's a little more special.
Yeah, you've got a gold medal in the line. What's going on with that?
I agree.
Yeah. Hey, you know, Kendall, I want to ask you something because, you know, you talk about people, young kids coming up and talking to you and then being inspired by you. And talking to some people, I got a couple of moles who've been around you, and they tell me you are a workout warrior. You put the time in. So give these kids, tell them what it's all about because, everybody says, I'd like to skate as fast as Kendall Coyne, which is going to be really difficult to do. But you didn't just show up at the rink. You work hard. Lay it out for these kids out there that you have to do the work.
Yeah, and especially for all those young kids, if there's one thing you can control, it's your work ethic. No one is telling me to go in the weight room. My parents never forced me into the weight room, but I knew it was something that was a big part of my game. I'm not very big, so I knew I needed to make up for that with strength. And so I'm constantly in the weight room 4 or 5 days a week, along with all of my other teammates too. Everyone is an extremely hard worker, hence why we were able to come away with the gold medal last year. But it's a big time commitment. I love it. But, you know, for all the young kids, you can control your work ethic. And if you don't have a weight room accessible, you can do push-ups and sit-ups in your basement. You can be outside shooting pucks in the driveway. And there's so many ways to try and improve your game every single day.
I think there's a good lesson in that as well, that sometimes your weaknesses or the things that people tell you are your weaknesses, right, you can use as motivation to get better in other ways as well, because we all have our strengths and we all have our weaknesses, and it's kind of what you do with them. This is crazy to say, Kendall. You've won a gold medal. You were the first woman to compete at the skills competition in the NHL, and I still think the best is yet to come for you. We really appreciate your time. Thanks for speaking with us, because I'm sure you're in high demand right now. We appreciate it.
No problem. Thanks for having me.